Hi everyone, welcome to episode 3 of the Business Talk Show. So let me add Dilrukshan. So I hope all of you are doing great. This topic is going to be quite interesting. You will find out more as soon as Dilrukshan joins.
Hi
Sasankar. Hi,
Good evening. Yes. So Sasank, are you ready for the topic? Which is we have a huge response for the topic.
Absolutely. I think it's one of the key elements when it comes to a business, isn't it, Dilrukshan?
Yes, exactly. So let's do a deep dive first to the topic. And what do you think is Asanka collaboration is? What do you think? You can start with the limelight.
So collaboration is the coming together of people, like-minded people, I would say, to share ideas and knowledge to achieve a common goal. I said like-minded because if you're not like-minded, collaborations would not work. That's my take on
it.
What is your definition of collaboration?
Right. Now, it's what I would ask a lot of people is there are a lot of strong people who have a strong brand, successful brands, but what are you doing with it? Sometimes I alone can't do many things together. For example, now look at for a platform like that. Let's take two companies. This is where one company will have a certain expertise, another person will have a certain expertise or a company. If they both join together, this becomes a collaboration, right? This is where two unique complementary skills join together and try to deliver something which is unique, right? So this is what I feel a collaboration. For example, a lot of companies have collaborated with each other. They either tap a big market share, they talk to a big audience, they bring variety. So collaborations can be wide, can be diversified. It's just you need to make a conscious choice. Okay, what's collaboration for you means? Why are you collaborating? Also, you know, what are you trying to achieve from a collaboration? So let's talk about our collaboration. So I think we met once live, and after that we both were commenting on each other's LinkedIn. Then we thought to decide, okay, let's go on a collaboration and let's tell people and what is our expertise on. That's where this entire business show is all about. So that was the birth of this. We have a huge vision, but that's where things comes in. So for me, collaboration is something two people join together for a common cause and trying to see how both the complementary skills are coming together and delivering a big objective.
What? Yeah, wonderful. So we are about to discuss on 3 points. That is why collaborate, the art of collaboration, and the benefits of collaboration. So if you ask why collaborate, there are plenty of answers that you can give for that question. So, collaboration is key for innovation. If you want to innovate, you have to collaborate. But as we said earlier, it has to be like-minded. People have to be like-minded. People who collaborate have to share the same ideas, and maybe agreeing and disagreeing is another story. But being like-minded is of paramount importance, Dilrukshan.
Right. And just to put some thoughts to your idea, so why collaboration is required today is now a lot of people have diversified skills. Not everybody is an entrepreneur, not everybody is a digital marketer, it's not everybody. You just need to understand you as a whole can do things as a person. Yes, you are unique, you have a lot of strengths. But when you join with someone else, this is where a lot of good things happen. Now, for example, I always think about Bharti Santosh. She's one of the always marketing examples where we bring. So Bharti has a set of unique skills. Santosh has a lot of unique skills. But the magic happens when they both come and join together. That's where the magic happens. So that's what for me a collaboration is all about. You know, two people join together. I think they both wanted to rock the music industry. So they made a conscious call. Okay, let's create industry which is unique, which their music is unique, the way they work is unique, and always wherever they see, they are on this. Some people can call this a partnership, but I would say they collaborated between each other to bring this brand called Bharti and Santosh.
That's correct. That's correct. And also, collaboration is important in problem solving. If someone wants a problem to be solved, or maybe one organization doesn't have the expertise to solve that problem, therefore you could collaborate with another organization which has the expertise to do it.
Right. Right.
So on and so forth. So it also brings organizations and people closer. Collaboration has the ability to do that. That's the magic of collaboration. So I believe people tend to collaborate. Now, if someone is engaged in or currently engaging in team sports, such as rugby, football, netball, so on and so forth, you have a basic understanding of what collaboration is. If you do not collaborate, you can't achieve that common goal. In rugby, if you don't have 15 players, you are not able to go and score that try. So likewise, people who have been in sports, who are sportsmen and women, currently employed in organizations, have the edge over the others. Maybe you may have different opinions on this, but I believe people who are into sports have a better understanding on collaboration.
Right. I accept you, Sasanka, because I have done sports, so I know that if it's a 15-member rugby team or 11-member cricket team, all 11 has to collaborate together towards this one objective. Because we always talk about the 96 World Cup team, what we had. So the main point which I say is diversified skills. We have a Sanjay Surya, we had a Romesh Kalvithan, we had Aravind De Silva, we had Arjuna, we had lots of people with different skills. I think that team collaborated a lot, and even if you see some of the teams who is doing currently good, it's a mix of a lot of people. It's that the skills. Together, I think Virat Kohli or Arjuna Ranadunga would have not done this magic. Because they both had leadership skills. But what happened was they brought the right people in and they collaborated a team which gave them the end results. So I feel today most of the people are worried. Now, I know a lot of startup entrepreneurs who are stuck in their business. Right, I'm telling you all, why don't you collaborate with other people and start doing together? You might be having a certain domain expertise, but here you are as a person, yes, you can bring that expertise, but you become huge, you become big when you're going as a team. This is where you are going to give a solution where you are part of it, and this is where you are playing on, because you will reach to a big audience. This is where you are speaking to a lot of people and you are giving a diversified big solution. As a person, yes, you can solve a small problem, but as a team, this is where you can solve big problems. So it's whether you want to solve a small problem or a small or big problem. Are you going to collaborate or compete? Because today competition is becoming day by day. It's becoming low because everybody is competing. Everybody wants a market share. Everybody has their dreams. But what differentiates you between someone else is, you know, how good you are willing to collaborate, how good you can work as a team, and how you can take it forward. That's what I think this collaboration is all about today. Let's go to the second topic, Sasanka.
Let me add something to this, what you said, right?
Right.
Now, we have heard this saying, survival of the fittest, right? But now it's outdated, right?
True.
Now they say survival of the connected.
Okay.
So that shows the power of collaboration in that statement itself. So it's about learning from each other. Be it a sports team, be it a corporate, be it an entrepreneur. If you don't learn from each other, it's very hard to collaborate. So I think talking about why collaborate, that is more than enough, Dilrukshan. So let's move on to the next topic is the art of collaboration. So what I want to say at the beginning when talking about this topic or the question is that many people complain. People just see the negative side of everything. You say pessimists see the negative side of everything, and the optimists see the positives of every negative situation. So why do you want to complain? It's just a matter of starting your own thing, taking action, and getting along with it, Dilrukshan.
True. So I would always say why collaborate is now, you need to understand you can always do a lot of things when you're joining someone. That's where teamwork comes in, you know, joining partnerships, everything comes in. So a lot of people have forgotten the fundamental rule is, you know, if you want to go a big journey, you need to always go with the team. If you want to compete in the small journey, yes, you can compete on your own. So this is where I would like someone to come and think, okay, everybody has something unique. Okay, but what are you going to do with it? Now, let's talk about the entire journey. Let me explain how this happened. So, me and Sasank has met over 2 years back, I think, at a networking event. We both shake hands between each other. And after that, I knew Sasank as a presenter, and Sasank knew me as a coach. So, we always, you know, was wishing each other on whatever we're doing. When I do a post, Sasank comes and wish. So, it was a common wish what we do between each other. So, where things change, where the game things is, when I and Sasank decided, why don't we do something together? Because Sasank had some complementary skills. That's where digital marketing, presentation, is comparing, is news anchoring. All those skills are what Sasank has, which I don't have. Now, my expertise areas are different. I can help a business to grow. I can help a startup person, to entrepreneur, to grow his business by 10x. Those are my things. I can go to a corporate and give a keynote. So we both thought, okay, I have about 3 to 4 skills. Sasank is, why don't we do a show where all the 8 skills are coming together? Now, today when we are talking at forums, when people are asking me to come and talk, now people know it's not, they are not listening only to one person, it's two people and about 8 to 10 skills what are being expertise for. So I think why collaborate is, if you want to bring some magic to it, if something, now if I'm going live today for the same time, what am I going to talk about is about a limited number of topics. Let's say Sasank is going live today, he's also going to talk about a limited number of topics. Now when we both live together, it's two perspectives, two way of looking at the same things, two way of doing different things. And it's always now a lot of people are asking us how this entire thing is. So we just wanted to give a lot of value to our audience. So Instagram is the first channel we choose because we both spend a lot of time together. So we are also planning to go on YouTube. We're going to plan to go LinkedIn, and also we're going to talk at different forums. That's a long ambition what we have, but at the moment while we are doing what we are doing, we just wanted to add, give massive to our audience the value in terms of the burning issues what they are. Anything you want to add, Sasanka?
Yeah, since you said that, I just want to say that let's give a hint, Dilrukshan. We are about to set an example in terms of collaboration, isn't it? We are planning to bring a global perspective to the business talk show as well. So we'll tell you more about it towards the end of the show, towards the end of the episode. So yeah, the other point is you have to focus or be present in the moment when you're collaborating. If you lose focus, it's very hard to align to a common goal. So you can apply it to sports, maybe undergraduates, corporates, entrepreneurs, so on and so forth. So being present in the moment is absolutely essential, Dilrukshan.
Yes. So I'll tell you, since I have a recruitment company on my own, so one of the things which is currently on demand, I would, if there's an undergraduate here, if someone is looking for a job here, if you are talking about your skills as a team where you have worked, apart the work, like even like I would say extracurricular activities, your Rotary Club, your Lions Club, when you are, if you are undergraduate in your university, what you are doing, these have a lot of points. Even in the ATA system, there's a lot of points for extracurricular activities, what you have done as a team. Because I don't need to ask you whether are you a team player or are you a teamer, because you have already proven from your CV itself or your resume itself that you are someone who has already excelled on that. So everybody who's, you know, who have a lot of time today, you know, who thinks, you know, want to excel in your career, one thing I always trying is trying to always to work as a team. Try to see how you can work with different partners, how you can work with different colleagues, how you can work with different, even somebody who's competing you on the same industry, when you both join together and do anything in your own, that's going to be unique, that's going to be big, and the way people perceive you is also going to change. Now, when me and Sasank started, now the first invitation what we got is from a global perspective who was watching our show and saying, look, I want to partner with you all and I want to be present in one of your shows. So this person is going to join us on most probably one of the upcoming episodes. He's going to be a global CEO coming and talking to us. So a small initiative, this is where things are moving out. But most of the people, either they go to this paralysis analysis mode Sasank I always talks about, because they always think about the pros and the cons, and will this be a good, will be this a hit show, will this problem. It's just a matter of starting. Go take the first step, start it, and then constantly change. Neither me or Sasanka didn't start everything on a perfect one. We started on, or we just wanted to start things. We want to constantly be learning. Every episode after this, me and Sasanka talks about the number of questions we answered, what are the good things went on, bad things went on. So we also learning on this journey. So there is nothing called a perfect collaboration. There's nothing called perfectly two partners. It's just about you understanding what skills you can bring, what skills the other person can bring. Together, what you can produce. Together, what magic can you do for this, for your audience, for the industry you are working, or for the company you are working. That's what matters a lot today. Over to you, Sasank.
Indeed, what you said was absolutely true. And what I want to add is that collaboration helps you to step outside of the comfort zone, right? Because one person is collaborating with another who has different skills. Then if you take A is collaborating with B, A doesn't have the skills that B has. So it is the stepping out of comfort zone for A. And vice versa. Right. Therefore, stepping outside the comfort zone helps you grow ultimately. Now, when we collaborate, I learn from Dilruksha, right?
Yeah.
I learn from his experience. He shares knowledge. We share ideas among us, so on and so forth. And even people tend to connect with us more and share their ideas on the show. They give inputs. About the show, what needs to be added, their opinions. So we should be able to accept that with a proper mindset. Dilruksha, this is very important. Adapting to or accepting what people say, sometimes it's very hard to do it. But we should be patient and humble to accept what the audience says. So because these shows are being done for the audience, for all of you. So we always accept what you say, and then you can always feel free and give us your ideas to improve this show, because ultimately this is presented for your growth, Dilruksha.
Yes, completely not your point, Sasanka. But now last week somebody invited us to speak on a topic on startups. So some people are writing to me and saying, I want your next show to be beyond this. I always say, you know, yes, we are going to do this and we will definitely take into consideration. I'm sure being entrepreneurs, we have this thick skin of listening to others and also understanding what the customer needs or audience needs. So constantly we are going to change topics. We are not going to stick to one. So the entire purpose of this collaboration is to bring entire Sasanka's expertise plus my expertise into game also. So we will be definitely constantly changing topics. So it's just you need to have a thick skin to understand, okay, in everything in success takes time. There's nothing called a shortcut. If you take a shortcut, yes, you will go clap your hands, but you will quickly fall down. So take things slow. So everybody who's here, who sent this question saying, can collaborations be always successful? That's a question like that, which I want to take it at this point. Okay, so without you trying your collaboration, I don't think even at any perspective or any business leader on can tell before even collaborating and doing things whether it's going to be a success or not. Only thing what you can tell is whether the two personalities can work together. That's done. Now, I'll tell you very openly, Sasanka, there are people who reach out to me and saying they want to do a live with me or they want to do a webinar with me. They want to bring me down. But certain people, when I speak to them, they're on this big analysis and paralysis board. They go into the depth of thinking so huge where they're not trained to take a small action. The smallest action is go get along with your partner or get along with your friend and just do this live. Whereas the next, you can think, you know, how you can scale, how you can take to the global level. Neither you or me wanted to plan to global, go to global very fast, but it happened because we just took actions. We are constantly doing it. So a lot of people are stuck. They know that they are part of different collaborations and they are part of different things. The entire group is silent. Either both the people are silent. You need to understand there is something called a push. Now, Sasanka, what happens is Sasanka sometimes push me and say, hey, look, where is the fly? The fly is not released. What are we doing with it? Should we do some changes? Whereas sometimes I push Sasanka and say, Sasanka, what are we going to do with this? This club is inviting. So it's about a between a mutual understanding that we both have, that I want to help you and you want to help me, and we want to take this initiative of the business talk show, intellectual show for all, everybody who want to learn about business, to give platform. So the question which was asked, Sasanka, was, you know, will collaborations be always successful? You want to add anything you think you want to add for that?
I think one of the best examples of collaboration is LinkedIn. When Reid Hoffman wanted to start LinkedIn, then he thinks again and wants to collaborate with his colleagues. And now it's a platform where you know what LinkedIn is now. So it's a platform where you have millions of users. So that's the power of collaboration. So that is a fitting example to tell you about the power of collaboration. And as you said,
right,
it's about the mutual understanding as well. That's why you need like-mindedness. Right. If you're not like-minded, you don't have a mutual understanding.
True.
Simple as that. So moving forward, what do you think is another important point in the art of collaboration, Adhikusha?
Now it's the open mind, I would say, Sasanka, because now if I was not open for collaboration, of you are not open, if you are busy with our own schedules, neither anything would have happened here. Right, so we had to take an extra step, because sometimes when people invite, always our answer is sometimes we are so busy being busy. So I would always say collaboration is a very open mindset. You need to understand when somebody to invite you, and for you to invite somebody, first and foremost, just you might be whoever you are, just put this ego out. Okay, collaboration is zero ego based. You just go speak to someone and see what you can add to that particular person and just collaborate and work. You might be the topper CEO or you might be an undergraduate. Just put your ego out. Just go and say with that particular person, hey, I want to do something with you. Can you collaborate with me? Because there are so many people who are out there who's willing to help today. Now, before I come on live, I was doing a show with a CEO of a global level CEO. I was doing a webinar with him. When I was speaking to him, I was feeling that, yes, someone has achieved so many things on his life. But, you know, we were sharing the same platform. He was talking first and I was talking second to that university audience. So it's just, you know, go and collaborate. Because when he invited me, I knew he's such a huge personality. But it was a great collaboration for me. So just have an open mindset. Say yes. Go and see what you can explore. And you can always make a decision. If you think, I would not say every collaboration will work. But if you think the collaboration is not going properly, I have so many examples where we have done different collaborations where people had different other objectives as well. So the collaboration didn't work. So have a common purpose. Discuss openly. Share what is required. Don't have hide and seek. Just share your partner. This is what I want. This is my vision towards this. What is your vision? If both the people are the same objective, it will definitely work. But if somebody is going on an X path and another person is taking the Y journey, this is where the constant, you know, there will be no mutual understanding of the problems are happening. It's your, you need to do this, I need to do this. All these responsibility problems will come because it's, you don't see as one part, one collaboration together. You both have two different objectives. So everybody here who's asking this question, you know, why should they, what they should they do for collaborations? Have one common objective, constantly take decisions based on your objective. Don't have personal agendas there. Work towards your objective. So every decision you make is always going to support towards it. Sasank, over to you.
Yeah, I think you hit the bullseye, Dilrukshan, by saying about ego. Ego is the number one quality that you should get rid of. Right? You have to get rid of ego. Otherwise, you're definitely going to create chaos. And my take on collaboration, one important characteristic, one of the important characteristics, one of the most important characteristics is trust. You have to be with reliability, integrity, and honesty. It talks about trust. So if you're not trusting the person you are collaborating with, definitely your collaboration would not be successful. I think since we talked about a bit of failures, I reckon that some of the collaboration failures have occurred due to lack of trust, Dilrukshan.
Yes. That's where, Sasanka, I see the personal agendas works. You don't have open conversations, I would say, in anything in your life. When you just speak openly to the other person and tell what you really want to achieve in terms of any collaborations, that's where other things happen. If it doesn't work, you both can take a mutual decision and move on. But if it works, work towards one common goal and, you know, take all decisions based on that. Because everybody will have their own things running on. But when it comes to let's talk about our show, business show. If you're not making decisions looking at the business show, if you're just making decisions on our platform, thinking about us, that's where things go wrong. So you are collaborating for a reason. Let that be the platform. Make decisions on it. Make work towards it, and always ensure, you know, just go and give you 100%. Today it's more about giving than taking. More you give back, things will automatically come to you. That's my learning. So I learned this from a networking platform, one of the greatest president who had. So he was telling me, just give unconditionally, so things will definitely bounce back than you're expecting. So what most of us are doing today is we are trying to see what we can get. So out of a collaboration, what can my benefits be? Always we are trying to get something, whereas we are not focused about giving. Whatever in your life, the more you give, God will always bless you abundantly, just giving you back loads. So just keep on giving in every collaboration you are working, and you will be definitely blessed with a lot of things coming your way. Sasanka, let's move to the next question.
Before that, now... Mm-hmm. Simply, Dilrukshan, collaboration is no longer a strategy, right? These are key element of long-term business success, right? It's collaborating is hard, but maintaining it for a long time is harder. It's even harder. So you need character. You may face ups and downs.
Right.
Misunderstandings, miscommunication, so on and so forth. But you should be fit to have a proper mindset and just go through the obstacles and achieve what you want to achieve.
Yes.
That's my take on this. So it's very important that we talk about failures as well, because failures are the pillars of success.
I'm sure, Sasanka, you and me both would have definitely had our own failures before coming this journey. So I've been working in my 15 years in corporate and 4 years entrepreneur. So I've done collaborations before. People had different agendas. People got along. So all these failures we have faced through, and I have gone through all those things. But every time something happens, this is my way of looking at it. I always learn from it. I always see where did I go wrong? What are the things which I did? And I constantly ensure that I don't do that mistake again. So there is nothing called a right formula. It's just try it out and always, you know, have a mutual interest and always see that whether your partner also has the same mutual interest and understanding and push each other. It's about if you are just sitting and waiting, then things happen, nothing will happen in your life. Just push each other, just, you know, push your partner, your partner push you, and it's one day you both will win. So when you win, you can celebrate. But the journey is has to be, you know, you both has to constantly talk, constantly communicate, constantly share between each other, issues, good things, improvements, everything, and just push both, and both people will go up in the career ladder. So whatever you do in your life. Over to you, Sasanka.
There is a question, Devuksha. What are the similarities that we should look for when thinking of collaborating or maybe planning on collaborations?
Right.
What's your answer to this?
Right. So if you ask me, the biggest similarity is where you are open for a collaboration and you would like to work for towards one goal, because a lot of people are today are having the problem of being open because their time is obstacle, either they are not ready to collaborate and they are always conscious about what will happen through a collaboration. That's point number one. And the point number two will be always, you know, what is your mutual goal? As a collaboration for anything what you do, have a goal towards it and have to work towards it constantly. If you don't have a goal, this is where you are going to go tried and testing. You will try something and if it works or not, you will just leave it because you don't have an end goal. You just start things, you will collaborate, you do it and see, because there are people who just go lives once. I have always seen they go live after that, you know. Now what happened to both of them or what happened to that entire team is something nobody knows. So what I'm saying is constantly push. There is something called a journey towards your end goal. Just push between each other and always, you know, work. The only similarities you need to work is you should have a mutual interest and also you should both be able to work together towards this common goal. Sasang, any perspectives from you?
Yeah, I think agree 100% with what you said. Personal agendas, and then you should be able to figure out the approach when someone tries to collaborate with you. So it happens through the experience you have, the knowledge you have, the worldview you have. It's a matter of dealing with people and learning from them. You meet different people. You meet different people with diverse attitudes. And learning about it and absorbing that. And then when you meet someone else next time, you should be able to figure out that this is not going to work out. Or if it is working out, you should be able to figure out that as well. So it's about being mindful and thinking about what you really want to achieve by collaborating. We talked about a common vision. So you should be able to guide, or the other person should be able to guide your entity or your collaboration to achieve that common vision. That's what I see.
Right. Any more questions, Sasanka, we can answer before we go to the next one?
There is a question from... since we are talking on a business context, profit making within brackets, aren't we supposed to think thoroughly about what's in it? Otherwise, we might lose all we have.
Right.
That's a very good question.
Yes. So can I answer first, Sasanka, for this?
Go for it.
So, right. Depends on what you want to do. For example, now if you are starting a business, right, together on a collaboration, from the first day you need to have a business goal towards it. You need to understand each and every month you both are becoming achieving your business goals and taking whatever the money you want to take back. Let's say the business perspective. Let's think you are taking an initiative like doing a program together, doing something together. This is where you might have to understand. It might take some time. For example, if somebody is thinking that they can launch a show today or whatever the show they are doing and they want to make money immediately, that won't happen. So both the people need to understand it takes some time. So two different perspectives. If it's business, yes, put up a plan. Ensure both the people are bringing complementary skills and both your skills are going to work together and have a target for it. Every month, work towards your target, achieve it, and ensure both the people are earning money out of it. That's a business perspective, more like a partnership-based model. But if you are joining for a common initiative, if you are joining to deliver some value to people, just want to be, and if you think that is not part of your main business, you are doing it just to speak to your audience or maybe to add value, then you need to understand it takes some time. So it all depends on how you look into it. Business perspective is different completely, and whatever the value addition perspective is different. So this is what I think in anybody who's willing to collaborate, and if they want to make money, they need to be make a conscious decision. It's going to be a short-term one or a long-term one. Certain business are there, you can make money short-term because from the first day, you will be earning, making money, and you can share between you both the people and just earn the money. But certain things take some time. For you to dig a lot of money, you might have to go through that entire journey of setting up things, you know, making a product and putting out things, customers valuing it, more and more people reading it, and then at the end of the day, you will get a result out of it as well. So, over to you, Sasanka. You want to add anything to that?
No, I think you actually summed it up. I reckon what you told was spot on, and it is about. Since we talked about success, it's a journey, and then it's about living your dream by going along that journey with whatever you have to learn from the person whom you're collaborating with. Learning from it, maybe ideas, experiences, so on and so forth. And ultimately, your common vision will be achieved. But it's a journey. It's not a destination. It's a journey. So we have a question, Dilushan. How do we manage conflicts in a collaboration?
So be open. So that's my number one perspective. Never keep hide anything. If during a collaboration or anything in your life, when you're working with someone else, just try open, make a call, drop a WhatsApp, drop a message and say, look, I just feel this is not going right because of this reason. What can we do about it? There's nothing that you can't solve. It's that we are not talking about it. We are always worried how will the other person think, the person in the collaboration, or how will the entire team thinks about it. But we are not solving problems here. Why don't you take initiative? Be open up, because for me, my model is I constantly open up to people. I always tell them, some people might like, some people not like. If it's nice, it's nice. If it's good, if it's good. If it's not good, let's work together. Let's see how together, both of us or as a team, how we can put our skills and bring this up, because nothing is going to be perfect at once. It's just you need to give this opinion, we share feedback, because I'll tell you what we do. Me and Sasanka, after this live, we every day we share, we make a conscious effort to make a call. We discuss what went right, what didn't go right. Both of us share some feedback where we both learn. So we both understand that we are at a sale at a very starting level. We have a long vision towards it, but we are on a journey towards there. But we constantly learn. We constantly learn and unlearn. We try to see what we can do. It's never my thing or it's never Sasanka thing. It's a joint thing. So constantly, why you get conflicts is because you have two different interests. How you can solve it, just have an open conversation, put your ego out, put everything out, just try to listen to a person and see, because everybody do something because of a reason. But if you don't know why they are doing it, we will never able to understand them properly. So openly just go and try to see what they can do and just try to learn from that and solve the issue before going to the next step. If you don't solve, constantly, this small issue become a big issue. By that time, when you are going to solve it, it's too late. So then and there, share things, take the perspective of the other person also, be honest, tell opinionly how did you feel about it, and also, you know, say sorry, say let's do it together. Those words shouldn't come in, and just move on. Over to you, Sasanka. Anything you want to add there?
Yeah, so it's about sharing what you know. Why do you want to be reluctant to share what you know? Because you won't take it back when you're leaving this world, isn't it? So it's about sharing an idea and sharing knowledge. When you share knowledge, you will have better understanding of what of the particular concept or particular idea or theory, so on and so forth. So when you share an idea with the person whom you're collaborating with, you get inputs from that person. Thereafter, you could brainstorm and ultimately come up with the breakthrough idea, which will maybe it could conquer the world. Velusha.
Yeah. Just to add a point, Sasang, I think this might be
yes.
related to the previous person who asked this question. So anything in life, when you are doing, if you are working with someone else, have clear-cut objectives. This is what we are going to achieve together. This is what the outcome of it, and this is where we are going together. Because when you don't have achieved key objectives, or when you don't know what clearly what you are doing, this is where you constantly thinking, okay, I'm going to spend my time here. I'm going to spend my value. I'm going to spend my knowledge. What am I going to get back? So this is where this open discussion has not happened, where you don't have an end vision where you are going. That's why you constantly question, why should I do this? What's going to in for me? Wow, is it profit making for me? So that's where I feel the discussion has not happened. This is where you just need to sit with the other person or with the team, sit together and see what are we going to achieve, what's the end result, and how are we going to take this forward. Because that's the only thing, because everybody comes and does things for a purpose. Nobody's just doing things for the sake of doing it. So, but you need to have a clear cut. Now, me and Sasankano, where are we clearly taking this show? What is our end vision? Where do we want to scale it? When are we going to scale it? Everything we know. We made a conscious decision to go on Instagram. We made a conscious decision we are going to go on a Thursday. So all those decisions have been made. So we both, after the show, we try to see, okay, what did we learn out of it? Simple as that. So Sasank, anything you want to add there?
And also, we are willing to come for physical sessions as well. Isn't it, Dilrukshan? So if you,
yeah.
you want us to deliver a session, maybe taking your input, you suggest a topic. So we will be more than happy to discuss about it. So it will be a two-way conversation. So we would depend.
So Sasanka, just to share something, yeah. So I just was, before coming, I was just talking to a forum, a community where me and another global CEO was doing. So what we both did was, he started, he finished at a particular point. I started from there and finished it. It's a small collaboration what they had. So we just had over a Zoom call, we discussed what we are going to talk between each other, and we just went and delivered it together. So it's
yeah.
just the understanding comes in. So it's a two-way
yes.
communication, that if I would have waiting till he makes a choice, so we both made a conscious choice to speak to each other. We were the two keynote speakers. So we went, we spoke, he touched upon certain things which I can start and talk, and wherever he stopped, I start from there. And so for the audience, it's a globe, it's a nice keynote, because both the people spoke on the same perspectives. But sometimes we wait and see for keynotes, different genres, different agendas, it's going here and there. So that's why I think this collaboration thing is not happening properly. They're not having a conversation. A very simple thing, over a call, if you think you want to see the other person over a Zoom call, just have a chat before you do things. Have now, I'll be very honest, we always set up an agenda for me and Sasanka. We know what we are going to talk. We listen, we go through your questions, what you get. We decide, choose certain questions, what we can answer, which is relevant for this. Sometimes we respond back saying, yes, we will park this question when this topic comes in, because we get a lot of questions on startups. We get a lot of questions on presentations. Okay? So we park those topics. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take it forward when you think, when we are doing relevant topics, and we are going to take it forward. Sasanka, there are some questions which have come to us before the show. Shall we shoot on those, just to give perspective?
Please do. Yeah, let's go ahead.
Yeah, so the biggest question what has happened to ask is, what is a context, or how do you set parameters in a collaboration? You want to start, Sasanka, with that?
You start, then I will chip in.
Yeah, so in terms of setting a parameter for any collaboration, when you collaborate with anyone, whoever gives the invite, you have a conscious choice to decide, what are you going to achieve out of it? Are you someone who's going to achieve something from that collaboration? Are you someone who's looking for profits out of the collaboration? Are you looking for something in? Just be very consciously make. And set a goal towards any collaboration, let's say today's keynote which I did before, or even this live show. What the entire goal is to give a lot of value to people and talk on certain topics. Now where you will go wrong is one person talking about collaboration, if another person is talking about another different topic, this is where you will completely get carried away. So this is where you need to set up your agenda nicely. You need to be very clear. Where do a person X starts? What does a person Y do? What are your role? This is where you set a context. Who designs this? Who designs that? Who goes live first? Who invites? Everything should be on an agenda. You should not go on live and then think, okay, who's going to do what? So set up a small agenda. That's what I call the context of it. And also try to see who has better skills on it. Now, certain skills, now I learned from Sasanka. Certain things Sasanka asked about me, what do you think about this? So it's about conscious learning also. If you think, you know, you can do everything, or if another person is doing, that person is going to do everything, this is where you think, okay, what's in it? Why am I doing everything? All those questions comes because you don't have a context on how the entire collaboration is going to work. Sasanka, over to you. You want to add anything?
Yes, I think in terms of presentation skills perspective, just adding to what you said, it's about preparation. You talked about having an agenda, having the topics what we're going to discuss on this episode. It's all about preparation. Even when you go for a presentation in the office or maybe at your university, you prepare. So likewise, before the show, myself and Devruksha, we prepare. We always have a connection on WhatsApp, so we chat and we just put down a list of topics and getting our inputs, and thereafter deciding what top, and obviously based on your responses as well. So that's why we selected power of collaboration today as the topic, because this is something that many wanted to discuss about. And power of collaboration is a massive topic, Roshan. It's huge. Because when we do these shows, these episodes, each and every episode, we do our own research. Isn't it, Dilrukshan? You do your research, I do my research. So when you do research, you realize how humongous are these topics are. What we know about this. This is just a drop. But what you do not know is an ocean. Even in a mindset perspective, you should be in that mindset. What you know is a drop, but what you don't know is an ocean. So if you have that mindset, if you are willing to learn, collaborations are easy. And failures would be much less. That's what I feel. That's my take on this. We do have another question, Dilrukshan, is it? Yeah, we do.
Go ahead, yes.
Do you have tips on how to approach another person for collaboration? There are many. Social media, for instance. So, as we discussed in the earlier episodes, connecting with people is easier than ever before. But you have to have an objective why you are connecting with that particular person. We discussed about a common vision, objective, aim, so on and so forth. So you have to approach them via social media. And maybe after approaching on social media, you could exchange your contact numbers and call, and thereafter meet in person. That is important, isn't it, Dilrukshan? We met in person. That's where all the impact came in. So meeting physically is important. That has a huge impact. Dilrukshan?
Yeah. So if you ask me what are the tips that I would like to give somebody, first one be, if you are inviting someone for a collaboration, always be very clear what is your goal and why are you inviting that particular person and what is that person's value addition is going to be. Right, so there are successful collaboration happens when both the people have complementary skills, when both people joining together can do a lot of things. When there are things which got failure as well, let's look at the other sides, right? Because you just go and invite someone who either doesn't have time or either doesn't have interest of doing it. When you just go and push someone, that person might not be interested. Now, a lot of people are failing for rejection. They are like thinking, if I invite someone, if that person says no, is it a big thing? Just do understand, not everybody is available for collaboration, because certain people are already very busy with what they are doing. It's just you need to see whether that person have time towards it. Also, whether that person has a complementary skill which you can complement with, and also you can bring this, whatever the dream or whatever the magic what you want to create, can you create that as well? So look at two things. First thing is, always when you invite, if that person is busy, that's completely fine. One day you can collaborate, or that collaboration might not never work. Also see whether you can work on a mutual interest, whether your complementary skills can be brought together one platform, and whether you can make a mutual interest about it. Because otherwise, you know what happens is, if you are in two different dimensions, I have seen this, I have tested this, I have done this, always a collaboration never works. This is where you are on one perspective, other person one perspective, you trying to come online, or you go to a keynote, or you do a webinar, you do a business together, you try to do achieve two different, too many things, nothing happens finally. It's always where you will take your journey. Sometimes people don't even look at their faces, bad things happens, everything. So come together. Today technology is so good, you can go on a video call, Zoom call, speak to the other person, tell, this is what I want to achieve, do you like to be a part of it? If it's a yes, take it forward. If that person gives you excuses, if it's a no, that, and all the excuses, just be happy, just say that thank you so much for being honest. Rather than just coming for a collaboration, not contributing, is better than that person saying no. So when somebody says no, don't get discouraged, don't get disheartened, don't take things personal. This person said no to me, I'll never work. It's that particular person's situation. He might be busy with something, he might be going through something in his life. So let that person come back to you. So always understand, collaboration takes time. Never rush on it. Meet on person or do a call and just see that particular person, see whether you have complementary skills. Also, while you are working, if you have any issues, constantly exchange between each other. Don't keep up to you. Being open always better than hiding and seeking. So always, those are the tips which I would like to give.
Yeah, I think
Sasak, anything you want to add?
Identifying a problem is essential. We talked about problem solving. Collaboration comes into play when you want to solve a problem. So if you can identify a problem, you could definitely collaborate with a like-minded person and get together and go on a journey, go on a mission to solve that problem, which will be beneficial to you and the entire world. So that's what I feel, Diluksha. Identify, because if you have a problem, there itself, your objective is 50% sorted. So you already have an objective. So that's 50% of your mission. The rest, the balance 50%, is what you do in terms of action. What do you say?
Yes, completely. I vouch for you, because then and there, communications matters a lot. Communicate, discuss, and there's nothing called weaknesses. Always thinks it's improvements, and try to see whether how you can help each other. That's what a collaboration is all about. If you are trying to be now, if you're always looking at what's in it for me and how can I grow, what can I take this collaboration next level, it's about you being on. So just try to work together, try to put a perspective together and respect each other's opinion. There's nothing called a right opinion or wrong opinion. Just try to understand each other's opinion. Whatever best contributes, whoever best contributes, take it forward. Just take out your ego and just, you know, take things forward. That's the only suggestion which I give. That's what I have believed, I trust, which I do with everybody who I work with. Give open suggestions. That's completely fine, rather than keeping it to you. And when things get big and when problem comes, and also just get out of this analysis versus paralysis. There's nothing happens in your life till you take actions. If you are planning, doing research, you know, putting up templates, a lot of things will happen. Yes, you will consume a lot of time. Yes, you will think a lot. By the time your analysis is finished, your already paralysis has happened. You will come up with a decision saying, I better not do it because it will fail. There's nothing called a right business model. There's nothing called a right everything. Everything you need to try and test and constantly tweak on it. That's how people get successful. Nobody who is successful, whom you think, who you aspire, who you get motivated, as started that overnight become successful. It's a journey. Start constantly improve, take suggestions, take a conscious choice whom to understand, whom to listen, and speak to those people. There'll be a lot of people helping out you when you're on a successful journey. Go forward, never step, always take one step forward. Anything to you, or Sasanka, you want to add before we go?
You're spot on. What's the time now?
I think it's 8:54. We have 6 more minutes to anybody to answer any question.
Time flies. Time flies. So
exactly.
We have spoken for 54 minutes. So what I want to add is that it's not about being friends per se, because this is more about realizing your own potential. Because when you think about collaborations, you improve on your own potential. You realize what you can do. Sometimes the other person whom you're collaborating with would compliment on your skills, and you can do the same by appreciating the other person's skills. So it's about realizing the potential and moving forward with it. It's not about being friends with each other. If you could do that, that would be wonderful. But more importantly, focus on each other's potential. That's what I see. So there is a question. Is it important to have clear self-awareness about why we want to collaborate with someone? When we collaborate, consciously or subconsciously, we do have objectives. Would you all agree on that?
Can we break the question into an answer, Sasan?
Sure.
What do you think?
No problem. So let me read out the first part. Is it important to have clear self-awareness about why we want to collaborate with someone? Let's answer that first.
Yeah.
It's about self-awareness.
So you need to, I always say, you need to always know what you are good at. Right, certain things today I say yes, certain things today I say no, because there are things which I can come and speak about. Right, there are things which I have done in my life, I have achieved in my life, who have the practical side of things. Any questions comes on that way, I can answer. Now let's imagine if somebody is coming and asking me to talk tomorrow about well-being, healthness, or something called digital marketing. This is where I'm going to say no. I'm going to say, look, I'm not the right person. Look, I have a partner who's there who can. Yeah, COVID-19, just go and partner with that particular person. So this is where I would like to say, better, it's important to understand what you are good at. Also understand what your partner is good at. You should not be in trouble by going and talking topics what you don't know. And you should not put a partner also in trouble by putting in topics which is not, because it's a comfortable topic. I used to put out a topic, Sasanka used to put out a topic. We both discuss and see, okay, can we both talk about it? Can we both together speak for this for maybe 1 hour or something? Can we answer questions on this? I will always say self-awareness is very important. If you are someone who is setting up things, you want to learn, and if you are looking for a platform to go and collaborate, just collaborate with the right people. Try to see whether your complementary skills and that person's skills will work together, and can you do something together. That's all what is important. So without you knowing what you are good, without you, your partner knowing what you are, that particular person's skill is, don't ever collaborate. What will happen is, when people ask questions, and when you can't answer, people know this show or whatever you are doing is not practical, that you are not tried and tested these models. You are just talking whatever is in the books. It's easy to talk whatever in the books, but telling practical things is very hard, because you have to do it and try, test, and then only come and share the perspectives. Sasanka, you want to add anything
absolutely
to that?
Absolutely. Absolutely spot on. I think that's why we collaborated. So you're talking about leadership. Startup entrepreneurship. So I joined to talk about presentation skills and personal branding, so on and so forth. So that's because we have done those practically, and we know the real situation. Maybe sometimes something you read in a book is not true until that happens to you in real life. Then you need to adapt. That's where self-awareness comes into play. So I 100% agree with you, Dilrukshan, and that's very important, self-awareness, understanding about yourself as well as what the other person is capable of. So the next part of the question is, when we collaborate consciously or subconsciously, we do have objectives. Would you all agree on that?
Yes, it's I completely agree. Without any objectives, I don't think there is any need for a collaboration. So together, what are you going to achieve is the first question. And when are you going to achieve is the second question. Is it a short-term goal or long-term goal? If it's a short-term goal, what are you going to achieve in the short-term context? Is it whatever the context you want to achieve? And also the long-term goal. So put your agenda or put the whatever the vision in a plan and try to take steps. Now I'll tell you certain things. Now we started to go on Instagram Live because that was the first option we took. It's not now people quite often ask me, Sasanka, why are you only doing on Instagram? You all have anything with Instagram to do? We have nothing to do with Instagram. That we both were available on that platform and we thought that's the first easiest way to go out and talk. Now if you are just waiting for example LinkedIn Live,
Please go ahead.
So if you are waiting till LinkedIn Live to come, streaming applications to come, now my team is actually currently working on to see how we can take this platform bigger. So they are working and they are speaking to different platforms to see whether can we go simultaneously live on a lot of platforms, how are we going to communicate, how can we answer a lot of questions. So we are trying to work on this model. It's just we made a conscious call. We were planning for about 1 or 2 weeks. We just thought we'll go live. So anybody who wants to just take action, start from the smallest thing. Just go start it. Anybody want, then see how you can expand, because rather than you starting, rather than taking that first step, you will never know is it gonna be a good success or not. Because when you start small, you can do all your mistakes. And when you become big, you can always do a perfect show, or you can do a perfect thing. You can have a lot of big audience coming and speaking to you. But it's a matter of starting.
Absolutely.
Just go, have a clear objective. Common objective, please understand, don't have two different objectives and do anything in your life, you will always go wrong. Have one clear objective and constantly make decisions, constantly make choices, thinking about your objective. Over to you, Sasankar.
And also we need to thank people who have given us opinions. Like you said, why are we only going live on Instagram? Because Instagram is the easiest platform to go live. And then definitely we are going on other platforms, Facebook, YouTube, and LinkedIn in the future. So thank you very much for your feedback. And that shows the interest they have in this, Dilruksha. So
today, Sasank, in the morning, someone was asking me whether have I made a strategic decision not to go live on Facebook. Then I was saying it's not that I've not made any strategy. It's just I choose Instagram because I spend a lot of time there. That's my easiest platform. Now, we don't have any favoration for any platforms, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. We actually want to go simultaneously live on all platforms. That's what our final objective is, even on YouTube. So we are just working on that. We are trying to
pick
down
Dilrukshan, I think, Dilrukshan, we should not delay this requirement. And let's get on the other platforms as soon as possible. Let's try to get on the at least on Facebook and Instagram from the next episode onwards. Yeah,
sure.
So
ready.
And then in terms of challenges, since you said taking action, how many times that we did try to meet up for the introductory episode of the Business Talk Show, COVID-19 came up, and once again few areas are under lockdown, and you know, people say various things about COVID-19, the infection, so on and so forth. But ultimately Dilrukshan pushed me, saying, Sasanka, let's do this, otherwise it gets delayed day by day. So I think then we just made a call, arranged the setup, and on the following week we started this. So now it's on. So it's going on. So every Thursday we will meet you. And today I think we have taken 10 additional minutes, Dilrukshan.
Yeah.
So we didn't feel the time flying. So let's say thank you very much to the audience, to the people who threw questions at us. Keep doing it. Stay tuned to the Business Talk Show. And before we leave, we mentioned about the collaboration we are about to get into. And this is about a global perspective. We would not mention the names as yet, but you would get a global perspective in the Business Talk Show in the future. So be ready with your questions. We are about to feature a global CEO. We have done the initial discussion with him, isn't it, Dilusha? So we are looking forward to feature him, and then it will be a local as well as a global perspective on the Business Talk Show.
So the power of collaborations, I think that was the most biggest example I would like to bring. So we are still on our third episode. By this time, a very global CEO at a very high level who's doing a lot of work in Singapore, he's working in Hong Kong, he's working with China, who want to come and talk in our show. So we did all it. We had a discussion with him. We were trying to see whether we have complementary skills to talk. So everybody who asked questions,
absolutely.
We first part thing is we just don't want to bring down people and for them not to talk. Because if they are not talking the same language but we are talking, the show won't go forward. So
absolutely.
We just thought, and
absolutely.
He has a lot of complimented things. So now we are on a group. Yes. We are just having a chat to see what topic we are going to show.
Chat,
so
yeah.
Maybe in one of the coming episodes, he will come and also, you will see a business talk show with three people. So one more person will also come. So one particular episode, maybe let you know. So we are always open for collaboration, and collaboration works for us also. So thank you so much for posting questions. Thank you so much for everybody sharing our posts, liking, commenting, and
let's mention few who have complimented us. Thank you, Archaeology. Thank you, Rosara. Srinath Ramamurthy, thank you very much. Cynthia, Vishal Solanki, Shume Chang, Ranuka Dharmaratna, Hadiz Abhi, I think, and the others who have joined. We mentioned a few names. So thank you very much for joining. We will let you know the next topic in the days to come. So until we meet you next Thursday, stay safe, take care, and think of collaborations with a common objective in your mind. Thank you very much. We'll see you soon. Prasanth Kadais and Dilruksha and Fernando signing off for the Business Talk Show. Good night.
Thank you so much. Good night.